As the AI revolution continues to grow and reshape our world, quantum technology is set to change everything we know about computing. Now imagine what happens when AI and quantum join forces. As we will see today, things are getting very accelerated. DeepMind recently proved that. They released a new groundbreaking AI model that brings practical quantum computers closer to reality. Just yesterday, I've met with the DeepMind team to discuss this breakthrough. So in today's video, I will explain how it works, why it's crucial for the future of quantum computing, and three potential outcomes of merging these two groundbreaking technologies together. Quantum computers have the potential to solve most critical computing tasks in just a few hours or even seconds, tasks that would take conventional computers billions of years to complete. However, unlike classical computers, quantum computers are extremely sensitive to noise. That's why we build this huge system around it to keep them cool. Even the slightest disturbance from environment like heat, vibration, or noise can throw their calculations off. This often leads to errors in quantum computations, making the results of the computations neither reliable nor useful. To address this problem, modern quantum computing using many different error correction techniques. David Deutsch, one of the most respected scientists in the field, said, "Without error correction, all information processing and hence all knowledge creation is necessarily bounded. Error correction is the beginning of infinity." One of the most popular methods for error correction is so-called surface code. It's when we use multiple physical qubits, multiple physical quantum bits, to encode a value of single logical qubit. And then these are used for error detection and error correction. And we will come back to this in a moment. So this method is very popular and used by tech giants like Google and IBM. The problem is that even with that, modern state-of-the-art quantum computers roughly experiencing one error per 1,000 operations. But in order to come to a practical quantum computer that can perform complex and long computations, we need to reduce this error rate to just one error in 1 trillion operations. As you see, we are quite far away from the goal. And it turns out that one of the greater difficulties lies in the decoding process, because noise in the qubits doesn't follow any particular patterns, but changes dynamically and unpredictably. This is where DeepMind's new AI breakthrough, AlphaQubit model, comes in.
AlphaQubit is a neural network that we've trained to act as a decoder for these logical qubits. And we get these sort of parity checks that are read out from the quantum computer that tell us something about whether an error has occurred, but they occur in complex patterns.
It's like a spell checker for quantum calculations, fixing errors and making sure everything adds up. To learn general decoding problem, AlphaQubit was first trained on thousands of simulated examples from a quantum computer simulator, and then fine-tuned on experimental samples from Google's Sycamore quantum computer, which actually once achieved quantum supremacy. Essentially, AlphaQubit is addressing one of the biggest quantum challenges, error correction, and it's used on Google's Sycamore quantum processor to distinguish whether a qubit, when measured at the end of the experiment, has flipped from the state it was prepared or not, and if yes, to fix the error.
Essentially, what we're doing, the analogy in classical information, which is stored in bits, is we're initializing a bit, which is either a zero or a one. And then we're encoding that bit using redundancy. So maybe instead of just, let's say I was trying to send you a zero or a one, I would send you three zeros, or I'd send you three ones. And there's some probability that some of those bits could flip. You receive 001. And now you're the decoder and you say, hey, well, two of these are a zero. So I think that Mike was trying to send me a zero. And so you're the decoder in that case. You're the piece of software that's deciding what is the bit that I originally sent you.
I must admit, I love Mike's explanation because it's very intuitive. That's what I'm trying to do always on this channel. However, from the discussion with the DeepMind team, in reality, this decoding process for quantum computers is way more complicated because the code they're used for decoding here is way more complex than this. Now, how does it work if the error is actually random? As we discussed before, each logical qubit is represented by several physical qubits. So every microsecond, we read the states of these physical qubits. Here, in case of three qubits, we read out an 8-bit number and feeding it into the neural network. The neural network updates its state to combine these new readings with the state that it had before. At each step, this state evolves. And at the end of the experiment, the network makes a prediction. It will give you 1 if it thinks the error occurred, or 0 if it thinks it didn't. And on top of that, it gives you the probability of whether the error occurred or not. Let me know your thoughts in the comments and consider subscribing to the channel to stay up to date with the most exciting and important advancements in the field of technology and ideas on how to capitalize on these advancements. Before we dive into the results of this research and the future of quantum and AI, I want to discuss with you technology that's already transforming how we work today. AMD Ryzen PRO processors are redefining of what's possible in the modern workplace. From small businesses to enterprise workflows, these chips are built to make your workday smoother. At the core of the AMD Ryzen PRO processor is a cutting-edge architecture that integrates the CPU, GPU, and a dedicated NPU on a single chip, enabling AI-powered application performance up to 1.8 times faster directly on your PC without relying on external hardware. Whether you are brainstorming with your team or using AI-powered applications, editing videos, or finalizing a presentation, the AMD Ryzen PRO chips deliver an experience that feels effortless. And this performance is paired with advanced security features and extreme efficiency. To put it into perspective, AI PCs powered by the Ryzen PRO series deliver up to 29 hours of battery life, giving you the freedom to work from anywhere, all day long. Now to the best part. AMD is making it easy right now for businesses to see the impact firsthand with the free Loaner program. Just click the link below to test Ryzen's PRO laptops for yourself and see the benefits it can bring to your business. Check it out through the link below and thank you, AMD, for sponsoring this video. Now, back to quantum world. According to DeepMind, AlphaQubit surpasses all existing decoders in quantum error correction. They've achieved error correction accuracy of 98.5%. And overall, it has reduced errors by 30% compared to the best-in-class correction methods. And that's a critical part in enabling quantum computers to perform longer and more complex computations, to enable them to tackle most important problems in the fields of quantum physics, quantum chemistry, and even quantum cryptography. These results look fantastic on the paper. However, still many challenges remain. And the first main challenge has to do with speed. Typically, superconducting quantum processors perform millions of consistency checks per second. This means you need to get the data and incorporate it into the decoder at this speed. Unfortunately, at the moment, they are still too slow for that. at least by a factor of 10, despite the fact that they're already much, much faster than the best decoders ever invented. So that's their focus at the moment, as well as improving accuracy to get to as low as one error per 1 trillion operations, which is essential for the next big leap in quantum computing. In general, over the last month, the field of quantum computing is regaining its momentum again. Let me know in the comments if you also noticed this. I see that the progress is accelerating, and I think it's happening because of the exchange of advancements and ideas between the fields of AI and quantum computing. And this fueling advancements in quantum hardware, algorithms, and error correction. And here I want to quote David Deutsch again, because he is brilliant and I'm a big fan of his work. And in general, if I would have a chance to do fifth degree, I would do physics. So here he says, "Quantum computation is a distinctively new way of harnessing nature. It will be the first technology that allows useful tasks to be performed in collaboration between parallel universes." Here, he refers to many worlds interpretation. Now, what happens when we combine AI and quantum computing? There are three outcomes here. First of all, AI accelerates the progress in quantum computing, which we already see happening right now, not just with error correction, but also with developing better quantum algorithms, like for T-gates, for example.
I see AI and quantum computing as really complementary technologies. Certainly, AI can enable and assist in the acceleration of quantum computing, which is still a very young technology. This AlphaQubit is a good example of this. Conversely, quantum computing, one of the major applications is in quantum chemistry. And for quantum chemistry applications, historically, there have always been good classical methods for handling systems that are kind of sufficiently simple. For more complicated systems where you have what we call strongly correlated systems, where like the entanglement is playing a big role, it's a lot harder to study these problems because, well, for the same reason that quantum computers are hard to simulate. Now, more recently, there have been advances in AI for these types of quantum chemistry problems. And so things like neural network states have really expanded the scope of what classical AI can do. But it's still quite a fundamentally hard problem for classical computing, because for some of these strongly correlated systems, I mean, fundamentally, they're quantum mechanical objects. And so in order to efficiently model a quantum mechanical object, some of the most interesting ones, we expect that we will need quantum computers. And those are the ones that where you can realize some of this like really big real world impact that we expect quantum computers to have.
From another perspective, we see that current AI methods are limited by hardware resources, and the development in AI is often outpacing the advancement in classical hardware. So quantum computing can be a solution to this problem and allow us to accelerate the AI models that will be too large to train on the classical hardware.
I would say that the two technologies are very complementary, and there are also ways in which quantum computing, we expect to be able to enhance sort of AI as well. You know, some of the people on my team and with collaborators showed that for certain learning tasks about the world around us, the world around us is fundamentally quantum mechanical. And if you're running an experiment where you have quantum information, using a quantum computer to learn from that data can require exponentially fewer samples. So it's exponentially more efficient than a classical AI could do.
At the same time, I had a discussion with several researchers that it can happen that AI can potentially take over some of the quantum computing applications, because AI, as we saw it with protein folding, right? It can find certain rules and principles, and in this way reduce the scope of the problem to the problem which can be solved in a classical machine. In my opinion, AI and quantum technologies are definitely not in competition, but they are synergetic. So when combined, then can solve bigger problems than either of them can do alone. And that's also supported by big investments from tech giants like Google, IBM, and Amazon. And I think the next big revolution in computing is going to be a combination of these two. However, for investors, these two are sort of in competition. That's why it's so important to diversify your portfolio, which I discuss in my course. Now, let me know your thoughts on mixing AI and quantum technologies in the comments. Let's continue our discussion there. And remember to check out our sponsor, AMD Ryzen PRO processors. As you may know, I'm a big fan of AMD chips, so very exciting partnership for me. Thank you for your support. Love you guys. See you in the next episode.